Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React MultiSelect Dropdown using the Create React App command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding data and customizing pop-up height and width. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create the app using the Create React App toolchain and use Visual Studio Code as my editor, and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I'll create a new application in the command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, I navigate to the desired location and run this example using the command npm start. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the MultiSelect Dropdown component. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and remove the styles from the app.css file. I import the Bootstrap 5 theme styles to apply them to the MultiSelect Dropdown. Then, I install the MultiSelect Dropdown package using the command npm install @syncfusion ej2 react dropdowns. To start using the MultiSelect Dropdown component, I import it from the ej2 react dropdowns package and include the MultiSelect component tag. Then, add a few styles to align this component. I will also add the placeholder property and assign the value as favorite sports. Let me run this application. See, the MultiSelect dropdown component is rendered with placeholder. And you will notice that no records are displayed in it. Let's see how to bind data to the MultiSelect dropdown. Data can be bound to the MultiSelect dropdown using the DataSource property. I declare the variable sports data and assign the array of string values, such as badminton, tennis, etc. I assign this array variable to the data source property. I also need to provide the text and fields when binding the data. When binding an array of simple data, both text and value fields will be considered the same. See, the MultiSelect dropdown component is rendered with sports data. I can also bind a JSON array to the MultiSelect dropdown. Now, I will modify sports data into JSON object containing two fields, ID and sports. Then I need to map the JSON object fields to the value and text fields using the fields property. Here, I map the ID field to the value property and sports field to the text property. See here, the MultiSelect dropdown is rendered based on a JSON object. To bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. I import the Data Manager from the namespace ej2data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the Data Manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property. I assign the remote data link. To make the server understand the request and process the response, we need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here I use the Web API adapter and enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the data source property. In the field settings, map the employee ID field to the value property and first name field to the text property. Declare another variable data query and create an instance of query to specify the field name to fetch from the remote data. Assign this to the query property in MultiSelect dropdown. I change the placeholder value to select employees. Check now and the MultiSelect dropdown is rendered with the remote data. Finally, let's see how to set custom values in the pop-up height and width. By default, pop-up width adjusts to multi-select input elements width, and the height is set to 300 pixels. I include the pop-up height property and set the custom value in pixels. Also add pop-up width property and set the custom value in pixels. See now, the pop-up height and width have been customized. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion React MultiSelect Dropdown using the Create React App command. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding data and customizing pop-up height and width. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.